table sat four complicated adults, my family. On deciding which place to go to get away from Bangalore's traffic and chaos, to enjoy a trip and relax. We were travel enthusiasts and had covered four continents. I had covered one extra, the fourth one, which was Africa. The four unconquered continents were the land of kangaroos, Australia, the Iceland, Antarctica, the land of football, South America, and Africa, which I had already covered. Europe, said the sister, because she loved shopping, but was instantly rejected by the mother because the temperature scale read minus 15 degrees. So the next option was Australia, but that too was rejected because the temperature scale read 52 degrees. So good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Where was the perfect place where we could go to? Finally, the place was decided with extreme weather conditions, but the best place we had been to, Morocco. On 22nd December 2017, we travelled to the heart of Morocco, the place of most of the Hollywood movies. Any guesses? Casablanca. When I landed there, we met our chauffeur, Jamal, who was to be there with us throughout the whole trip. The place was different, the air was different, the people were different, and there was one peculiar rule which I saw there, that the Moroccan currency, dirhams, was to be given back while leaving the country, and it was only available at their exchange rooms. On every trip, there's something new to learn. And on this trip had to offer me three things. The first being, nature is magnificent, but it is the greatest teacher we all have. We started out the journey at this tall, magnificent marble structure of the mosque Hassan II, because it had the tallest minaret in the world at 210 meters. We continued to places like Rabat, the city for trade, Fez, the blue city, and the best part of my trip was the drive from Fez to the Sahara. Within a span of 200 kilometers, I saw extreme condition change, like you would see a happy me turn into this angry me when someone stole a slice of pizza from me. We stopped at this place called Efrin, which had a temperature reading of 3 degrees Celsius, but breathtaking views. Then we drove in through the great mighty range of Mount Atlas, which came right out of my history textbooks, with snowfall and the temperature dropping to minus 4 degrees. And there, alas, in front of us was the great, vast heat punisher, the Sahara Desert, and boom! The temperature shot up to 52 degrees. With a few meters of visibility and rain pouring down hard on the windshield, I had seen that to snow and heat waves, which actually sends chills down my spine. We rode into the desert with camels to see the huge ball of fire, the sun, sinking down into the sand dunes like the iconic Titanic. And a freezing night at the tents of the kasbahs with different people, cultured people, coming there in unison was a hell of an experience. Nature is powerful and the greatest teacher we all have. The second thing which was funny was extreme human behavior, good and bad. Me and my dad are huge foodies, and we had this ritual that we would never eat namma food. We would go there and try out the traditional local food of the place we were in. So there we went, ordered the Moroccan traditional food, tagine and couscous. At every Moroccan restaurant, I saw this beautiful habit of free bread, olives, fruits, and few products which were given in abundance. There is a saying in Urdu, Neki kar darya mein dal, which means do good and put them in the ocean of goodies and forget about it. Finally, those rats in my stomach came to a standstill when the food came. And there I was, ready with my camera, trying to capture this perfect shot. And kachak! My appetite was sliced. Don't look so bewildered. It was the one thing I hated. Upma. Given a fancy name, couscous. So I managed to battle the strong army of upma and make my tummy victorious. Now you may wonder where the contrasting behavior is. But this came at the end of the trip, when I was returning back to India to have idlis and biryani because couscous was no more going down my throat, we stopped at a petrol pump for breakfast. And unknowingly, my mother left her purse in the car. We went with trusting this driver of ours who had bought us a huge order to munch on. On returning back to the car, my mother saw her Aadhaar card lying in the seat. Suspicion building up, she started counting the money. And to her amazement, $100 bill was missing. Finally, the Aadhaar card had linked the mystery of the lost $100 bill. As you all guessed, the person who we trusted, who was with us throughout the trip, who shared a deep connect with us with his stories, jokes, had all come to an end with a snap of a finger. That day I realized that no country or place is good or bad. It is the people who make it good or bad. Lastly, the greatest realization I had was travel treasures. Travel experiences gives you memories that you save. And from deciding a place to go to the extreme conditions which we had experienced, are memories to cherish and lessons not to be forgotten. We all love traveling, isn't it? When you travel, you not only see the spectacular creations of the Almighty, but you meet different cultured people who teach you amazing aspects of life. On this trip, I had two things. One thing, nature is the best teacher we have. And the second, that a country is not good or bad. It is we, the people, who make it good or bad. Traveling has been my way of learning. What is yours? Thank you.